Welcome to Wharton Computing Research and Innovation's 2-Minute Training Video, HPCC Batch Jobs with qsub. In this short video, I will describe how to use Univa Grid Engine's qsub command to run research code scripts on Wharton's High Performance Compute Cluster, HPCC, as well as operate a few more simple command line tools on the cluster. Let's get started. Wharton's HPCC uses Univa Grid Engine software to help you run your code. Grid Engine software is a layer between you, the researcher, and the cluster. Its primary mission is to make sure that a large number of researchers can simultaneously do research without interfering with each other. The most important job submission command that you will use to run batch jobs on the cluster is qsub. Let's explore the qsub command in greater detail. Open your SSH client, MobX Term in Windows, or Terminal in OS X. SSH to your username at hpcc.wharton.upenn.edu. Using the Linux cp command, recursively copy the contents of the user local demo directory to your home directory. Using the Linux ls command, list the contents of your home directory and note the new demo directory. Using the Linux cd command, change directories into the demo/matlab directory. Now using the cat command, take a look at the contents of the readme.txt file. Also use the cat command to take a look at the demo.m MATLAB code. Since we're already copied over the MATLAB directory and files, we're ready to run some code with qsub, job script, demo. Type or copy paste that command now. Your job has been submitted. Take a look at the qstat and qram commands. What do they do? When your job is complete, it will no longer show up in qstat or qram. To look at your output, use cat to view the JobScript.o files, where xxxx is a job ID of your job that you just ran. To examine job details, use the qact-j job ID command. There are lots of interesting data points to examine. Notice max vmem and ru wall clock as a couple of examples. Using the up arrow on your keyboard, resubmit the job script with qsub a few more times. Examine the running jobs with qstat and list the output files with ls. Notice your jobs completing as you continue to run qstat. List all the files in the directory in reverse date order with ls-ltr. If your job had problems because it was running out of RAM, you can increase the RAM the job will be allowed to use with an option to qsub. Find your qsub command, and using the arrow keys and keyboard, add -lm_mem_free=10g and submit the job. If you wish, use qstat-j job ID to verify the RAM request was honored. If you will be running a lot of these jobs, you might give the job a name by using the -n name option to qsub. You could also use the -jy option to combine error and output from the job, something I always do. If you have a long-running job, you might use the -me option to send yourself an email at the end of the job. You can also specify the name of the output file with the -o option. Submit it, qstat it, list it. For more options, take a look at the Research Computing website's job management page. Here you will find detailed explanations of some of our favorite options to qsub and details on other Univa Grid Engine commands. Thanks for watching.